Well, Dennis is my cousin.
Okay.
So I didn't know Anne till she married Dennis in the early 70s, mid 70s.
Okay. I became really close friends with Anne, Dennis and Greig and Hollie when Hollie must have been about 16, 17. And they were a lovely family, a pleasure to visit. And we had holidays with them and we had Sunday trips. You know, it was just a lovely friendship.
Very good.
And to this day, I miss her a lot. But
yes, I met her when she was born, obviously, for about a year. I met her a couple of times. And then she cut herself off from all the family for about 16, 17 years. So I never saw her or her parents until Hollie was about 17, 18. Okay. None of the family did. She moved away and didn't communicate with anybody.
So neither of you ladies knew Hollie when she was a six-year-old?
No. Oh, no. No. She was a baby last time I saw.
And they were living in Brazil when Hollie was 6 years old.
And so what sort of things did you do together?
We went shopping, we would go runs on a Sunday, and pit lochry, and went on holiday to Portugal and saw their lovely house that they got, and just had a lovely time. But to visit, they were just such a happy family, and I loved them to bits. And I loved Anne to bits, and still miss her to this day, really. But such is life. She was a happy, happy little girl. Yeah, she had loads of attention from her Uncle Roy, who lived in the upstairs part of the house. And it was just a lovely, happy family. Oh, she was a spoiled wee thing. Everybody loved her, you know. And she's lost everybody, absolutely everybody. And to say that they had to flee Scotland is absolute, total rubbish, you know. Who was bothering them? Not a soul, you know. So that's lies.
So why did she move from Scotland?
You tell me. I have no idea. Probably because she'd done such an evil thing by naming all of us that she couldn't face us. So it was easier to run off, I would think. What other reason? They were a lovely, happy family, and Greig was so caring and
good for Hollie. Yes, Greig was a good brother
too. And Dennis loved her to bits, and she was a daddy's girl, wasn't she? Yep, and Anne was a super mother to her. She was happy as could be, absolutely. But I would wonder how happy she is now.
She first made allegations 10, 11 years ago against me, Dennis, and myself. Okay. But then it was 2 years ago when the letters were sent round all the neighbourhood.
Yeah,
it was mainly, she just wanted revenge on Dennis for leaving her, I suppose, and just accused him of being a paedophile.
Yeah,
me as well.
But she left him.
Well, whatever.
And why do you think she accused you?
I have no idea. I never even had a crossword with her.
Jealousy, because you were close to Dennis?
Yes, probably. She was a very jealous, insanely jealous person. But
I'm not too sure, but she was convinced that her mother must have had a lot of money and there appeared to be none. But I think this situation arose after
Roy
committed
suicide.
And Anne knew it was suicide.
She was shocked at that, as she would be.
Of course she was.
Yes.
But she was in no doubt of it being suicide then.
No, it was only after she got in contact with Robert Green that she
fantasised
then, yes, that perhaps he was murdered, which he wasn't.
And
it would have been after her brother's suicide she got worse.
She became obsessed.
That's absolutely when the marriage broke down because of it.
And this business of Dennis beating her up is absolute rubbish. And I was there the night that Dennis was supposed to have thrown a hoover at her. Well, she was in hysterics and phoned me to come round. And okay, there was a little bit of blood and a little scratch. Now, my opinion would be that there'd been a row and Dennis had just thrown the hoover into the bedroom and maybe nicked her. But she was in a terrible state.
Then she was running away in the middle of the night with her nightie on.
Yeah, and bare feet.
Yes, she was doing all sorts of silly things.
And Greig was trying to get her back and she bit him in the arm.
She was just unstable.
Yeah. And nobody's judging anybody for being maybe slightly mentally ill. I mean, pressures of life can bring that out in anybody.
Yeah, especially after her brother.
Every one of us are friends. Dennis and I took her to the GP. And when she came out, she said, look, see, he's one of them. He's against us as well. Absolute rubbish. Now, any sane person would say that that was absolute paranoia. And it just got worse and worse. Two and a half years ago, and Sylvia, it was you that sort of told me about this stuff on the internet. And do you remember when we looked it up in your laptop? I sort of went, I thought it was hilarious. And then I thought, this is not hilarious, this is real. And I was absolutely mortified. So that was that evening.
You're so let down, such a shock.
Yeah, and I went back and started looking through all the stuff on the internet, and the more I looked, I just was devastated. They came and interviewed all of us, and it was about a 2-hour interview, wasn't it?
Yes.
Easily. Yep. And then the whole thing became totally real and horrendous. Yeah. Absolutely.
Yes, it was awful.
After they interviewed you, I mean, what line were they taking?
They knew it was just a load of...
Yes, they had known for 10 years.
Yeah.
Anne had been trying to get lawyers to take her on, lawyer after lawyer for 10 years, and every lawyer took her on and then threw her out because they could see that it was untrue.
Did Robert Greig ever speak to you personally?
No.
You're joking, no.
No.
I mean, if Robert Greig was here now, what would you say to him, or would you not want him to be here?
Well,
now?
I was willing to go and visit him in prison and just say, you know, what on earth could possess a man of his age and his so-called intellect
to be so gullible?
To just believe anything that a female splurted out and such ridiculous things.
Yes.
Without investigating, without contacting anybody, just beggars belief.
Yes.
Really.
But well, one of them gets upset when she thinks about it, and
because of her dad, eh?
Yes, it's horrible hearing things about their dad, which isn't true, and all over the internet. But they've got used to it, and now they never speak about it, and their friends don't bring it up, but it's always there.